So, my name is Samia Dali, and in this presentation I tell you something about augmented transition networks, why this is roughly a summary of those cited paper below. First, I give you some general information about augmented transition networks. They can roughly be compared with finite automata, but they have a storage, so that makes them similar or comparable to pushdown automata. And their processing is also very similar. So they are in a state and they are processing one input word at a time and taking transitions into other states. While on the transitions, some more actions can be performed. And similar to finite automata, an input string is accepted at the end if the augmented transition network is in the final state, if the whole input has been read, and if the storage is empty. There's some weaker form called recursive transition networks. They can only perform push and pop operations, and they have those additional pushdown store, which makes them actually equal to pushdown automata, and like those, they can only represent nested but not crossing dependencies. Then there are the augmented transition networks, which are like recursive transition networks but with an additional register that's like a storage on which different actions can be performed, like set R means a value is stored in it. And with the help of this register, the deep structure or the syntactic tree of a sentence can be represented. Also, the transitions can be labeled with some conditions, so that means a transition might not always be possible. The augmented transition network can represent crossing dependencies and is actually as complete or as powerful as a Turing machine. Now I have prepared an example for you. Here, left above, you see the rest of the input we are about to read. Here we have our pushdown store where we store things in it, and some register where we also store different kinds of values in it. Then here we have the actual automaton consisting of different states and transitions. And actually, you might think that this arrow points to the next line and some kind of line break and goes on here, but that's not the case. Actually, these are two parts, two different parts of the automaton. And this arrow actually points out of the automaton. You see the states always are named with some slash in it. And this means the part left of those slash means that's the constituent we want to read. And the right part tells you what we have already seen of that. And here below you see some definitions of those transitions. And what you are not seeing on this page due to limit space is a lexicon which the automaton can use and which tells them and gives it information about the words. And what you also not see is the definition of all those actions. And the things that changed on this page or that are of interest, that's what I have labeled green on each page. Here we are starting in this state. This is the initial state because it says we want to read a whole sentence and we have not seen anything of it yet. First, we are performing, the only thing we can do now is to perform those, to take those transition. This transition actually does not lead into this state, But we are storing the name of this state in the pushdown store to remember it. And then we are jumping into this state. That's the label on those transition. And from here on, we can read the NP. Here in the transition table, you see that the condition for this transition is true. So that means we can always use it. And the actions say that we want to set a value in the register, and that's a subject with a placeholder. That's what I have done here. Now we are consuming the first input word, which was the. This transition can always be taken, and then the transition says we are storing those determiner with the respective value in the storage, and that's in the register, and that can only be performed because the automaton looks into its lexicon and sees that the is of type determiner. Then we are taking the next transition. We are consuming the next input word, which is man. The automaton looks into its dictionary and sees that man is a noun. And the action says that we are storing a noun with that value of the input word in the register. So now we are done with reading the nominal phrase. We can now take this transition, which there's no action to be performed here, but there's one specified on the transition on those arc. And now we are done reading the NP, we can compose it. So we are reading the last value from the pushdown store, which was the name of the state where we have been before we went here. So we are going back to this state. And also the action NP build says that we are building together those NP which fills the subject position. Then we are reading the next input string, which was kicked. We are going those transition and then into that state. The condition for those transition says that we can only take those condition if the word is in form tense, so the automaton looks up kicked in the dictionary. And then what it does, the next condition is that we have subject word agreement, so the forms of those has to match. And then the verb according which with the tense is stored in the register. So get form tense is the function that returns the tense from the dictionary, and here is the same function which is then used to store those value in the register. And also the present form of the verb, the not inflected form, is also stored in the register. Then here from this state, we have two possible transitions. This is one we cannot take because it says as a condition we can only take those transition if the verb is intransitive. So that means in case we had an intransitive verb like sleeps or something, then we wouldn't need to read another NP and could just skip it. But in this case with kick, we cannot do it. But we can use the other transition, and then we are going back to those NP. We are storing the name of this state now in the pushdown store. And we can only take those transition if the verb is transitive, that's fulfilled, because the automaton looks it up in the dictionary. And we want to store some object which we don't have the value for yet. Then it's basically the same as we had before. We are reading the and store it as a determiner in the register. Then we are reading ball. And then we are composing the NP and putting it into the object position. Then we can use those last transition, which leaves the automaton and composes the whole sentence. The table says we can always use those transition. And well, S build puts together all those different values to the syntactic tree. That's some kind of bracket notation where you have the childs in where you have no, you have subtrees in one pair of brackets, and you see that it looks similar to syntactic trees you might know from your courses, but there's an additional past specifier in it. And also the augmented transition networks accept the word because the stack is empty, so this one is empty. We are in a final state, which is where we left the automaton, that's our final state. And there's no rest input left to read. So the automaton is done with reading those sentences. Here we are having some more information. The augmented transition networks were made as a model for sentence comprehension. So that means they shall work similar to the brain. So if a sentence is very difficult because it's very nested, then it shall be also the processing of the sentence shall also be more complex. So, for example, I have the two sentences 5a and 5b. I have some here. 5a is the man, the girl, the cat, the dog bit, scratched, loved, ate ice cream. This is actually a grammatically correct sentence, but really, really hard to understand. Compared to 5b, the dog bit the cat that scratched the girl who loved the man who ate ice cream. This contains the exact same information as 5a, but it's easier to understand. So that means that 5b would also be easier to be processed by the augmented transition networks. That means it would be less nested. So that means, yeah, the complexity of the processing shall represent the complexity of the sentence. What you might have seen that the augmented transition network works incrementally. That means it processes a sentence from the beginning to the end, one word at a time. And also the processing is somehow linear because the parsing time does not increase with the length of the sentence, but with the complexity of the sentence. So that means that a longer sentence does not mean that the automaton takes much longer than void. And also the augmented transition network shall work, as I said, similar to the brain. That means if there's some ambiguity, the automaton, as you might have seen, it would take the first transition it can use, and if it fails in a later step, then it can also go back and try out the other possibility. With those register overwriting, it's similar to a transformational grammar. The transformational grammars that were, when I remember correctly, they can transform an active to a passive sentence. And in this case, the complexity of the augmented transition network or of the processing is how many transitions have been tried and how many activities were on the register. Now I have another example with a passive sentence. Now we have the same nearly the same sentence as before, but it's just in passive. And the and we also had to extend the automaton by some more transitions and some different actions. So as before, as in the first example, we are reading the ball. So that's as before, we are getting now our subject, the ball, in those bracket format. Now we're reading the word was. At this point, the automaton does not know that it's a passive sentence, so it tries to pass it as an active. We are reading those input word was. The automaton sees that's the past form of be and stores it like this in the register. Yeah, as I said, it does not know that it's passive at this point. And now we are reading the word kicked. We are using this transition, which says like before that, which asks if the word kicked is in past participle. Sorry, I missed the translation. Then also if kicked might be the passive form of something. And also for this transition, the word be has to be already stored in the register, and that is the case. And in this case, the actions say that we are setting what was the subject before shall now be the object. The subject itself shall be set to nil, or it's like null, it's not set. And also the verb shall be set to the word we have just read. So in this case, it's kick. Because the automaton read kicked, looked up in the dictionary and found the base form kick. Here we have again two different transitions we could take. The first one would allow to go here, but it would fail in this step because the next word is by and the automaton would not find it as a determiner in the lexicon, so we cannot take this transition, and if it would try out it would have to go back. But we can now use this transition, which we can use. So this one we had before this transition, but now it has been extended. Before it was just for intransitive verb, but now it can also be used if the object has been set, and that's now the case for this passive sentence. And that means we can now just go to, without doing anything more, we can go into this state. There we have the transition out of the automaton and to build the whole sentence. But now we have the condition that the subject must be filled. Maybe you're wondering why this is, because there could be passive sentences without a subject. We will see this later. Instead, now we are taking this transition. The word before has been by, so we now read by taking those transition. It's also written here, the word has to be by. The condition is that the subject is null, so this is true because we have null in those registers, so now we are in this state. And we can take this transition, where we are reading the next nominal phrase, which was the man. And I shortened this down a bit. We would go through all this part again and build together now those new subject. So that's what we are I shortened this a bit. Now we have our subject. And we can leave our automaton. Now our subject is filled. We can build together the sentence or the structure of the sentence, which is the same one as in the first example. And also, because our stack is empty and we are in our final state and we read the whole input, the sentence has been accepted. So in case we had no subject, so in case we did not have the man here to kick the ball, then we would have taken this transition. There's something wrong with the arrow. So we would take this transition number 12, which we can also use when there's no subject. So, and would also only make sense if we are not about to read anything more. And then it says, when we don't have a subject, we can just insert someone into it. So that means we would always have some subject specified in our deep structure, even if it was not in the sentence. So, and now about some criticism. As you have seen, the augmented transition networks work very incrementally, so it processes a sentence from the first word to the last one, one at a time. And the augmented transition networks, they were really popular in the 60s and 70s. Those Luna system was a really big implementation, and as you might have seen, it's the points they are not really used anymore today is they are really hard to maintain. So we just wanted to make it process passive sentences, and we had to add several new states and transitions and add new conditions and so on. And so this makes it hard to maintain. So anytime you want to change it, you have to look through it if it not breaks anything else. They are Turing complete, so that means they are really hard to look through. You can easily make a mistake somewhere. And well, this was somehow an easy example for English, and it would be even harder to implement in an augmented transition network for languages like German, where we have no strict word order and we have much more morphology, so you would have to take care of many more cases. So that's they're really hard to use and to maintain, so, and you have to do it all by hand. Well, there were some automated generated network somewhere, but then they are still hard to understand. And that was my presentation. Thank you for your attention.